Let's talk about the depletion of natural resources. So first, what is depletion? So depletion is going to be when you allocate the cost of a natural resource over that resource's useful life. It probably sounds a little familiar because it's similar to depreciation. So depreciation is when we allocate the cost of equipment or a building over that asset's useful life. Depletion, you can think of that as almost the depreciation of a natural resource. So then, what's a natural resource? So those are going to be assets that you physically extract and can only be replaced by an act of nature. So think of it as things that you are taking from the earth. Oil, gas, timber, minerals, right? Those are all examples of a natural resource. So the first thing that we need to do when we are figuring out the depletion of our natural resources is to find our depletion cost per unit. And we see that equation on the screen now. It'll be your total cost minus your salvage value, all divided by your total estimated units available. Once you have that, you can then multiply the depletion cost per unit by the amount of the natural resource that you extracted to find the total depletion amount. And we need that total depletion amount because that's what we will then put into our journal entry when we have to record our depletion. So we see the journal entry on the screen. It's a debit to inventory and a credit to accumulated depletion. So accumulated depletion, just like accumulated depreciation, is a contra asset. It's going up with this credit, and it will be subtracted from the natural resource on a balance sheet. Let's talk about your inventory real quick. Why is your inventory going up? Well, we now have more of that oil or more of that mineral, right? Because we have extracted that from the earth. So that inventory is going up, but we also need to show that we are depleting that natural resource, and that's why we have to also include this contra asset. Let's talk about this example problem. It tells us that Antonio Company purchased an ore mine for $15 million. The mine is estimated to have 50 million tons of ore and no salvage value. In the first year, 10 million tons of ore are extracted. We need to first determine the depletion cost per unit and then prepare the journal entry to record the depletion for the year. So first, your depletion cost per unit. Again, that's your total cost minus your salvage value divided by the total estimated units available. So we plug in what we have from the problem. We spent $15 million on this mine. It doesn't have a salvage value, and it's estimated to have 50 million tons in the mine. So 15 million minus zero divided by 50 million. And this will give us a dollar per ton amount. And when we do that math, we see that the depletion cost per unit is 30 cents per ton. So each ton that we take out of this mine, we're going to say that we are depleting that natural resource by 30 cents. So then we need to prepare the journal entry. We know it's going to be a debit to inventory and a credit to accumulated depletion. We have that framework already set. Now we need to just figure out the number that we put in here. So that's where this 30 cents comes in that we just found. It's 30 cents per ton. We're told that in the first year, 10 million tons of ore are extracted. So we take those 30 cents, multiply it by our 10 million tons, and that comes out to $3 million. So our inventory is going up by $3 million because we now have $3 million more of this ore that we just extracted. But we also need to show that the mine doesn't have as much in there anymore. So we have this accumulated depletion account to take care of that.